So today we got a Ford Edge that we're looking at the brake condition on. So a customer complaint was high speed pedal pulsations. Okay, we know the customer of the vehicle, and this vehicle does not get driven very often. It actually only has 25,000 miles on it. When we do the inspection, if we were to just look through the wheels, you know, if you look at the rotor surface, it's not very rusty, it's pretty smooth. And if we were to peer through and actually look at the outboard pad, there's a lot of pad life left. Now, this goes to show how important a full inspection is. Okay, because if you were to look at the inside of this pad, or in the inside of the rotor, it tells a different story. So now looking and comparing the outboard pad to the inboard pad, you can see the thickness difference with these two pads. Okay, so here's the outboard, there's a ton of life left on this pad, but then if you look at the inboard, you know, that's almost worn out. Okay, now we look at the surface. Yeah, that surface isn't bad. It's a little bit dirty in that groove there. But now the inside pad, okay, you can see them deep grooves, right? That's gonna tell us an extreme story right there. So again, when we're talking about this outside pad on this rotor, that's a very clean material. Now remember that inside pad, these grooves. Look at that inside of that rotor. Okay, this is caused from rust jacking. Okay, that's from the inside of this rotor getting wet and then not being able to dry off. Okay, now remember, this vehicle does not get driven very often, so, and not very far. Okay, so the outside has a ton of airflow. Okay, that is allowing it to dry off, where the inside just stays moist and allows that rust to build up in between the ceramic layer and the rotor itself. And that's where we get this flaking. So what would typically cause this? Okay, first, we did our inspection, we see the issue, right? Now we need to see what's actually causing it, okay? We know our pins, okay? We look at our pins, they move nice and freely. Now we move to our pads. That inboard pad cannot move, okay? And that's what would cause it. Now, moving it out, the pistons have enough pressure to be able to push that pad and just keep grinding against the rotor, whereas you still need it to be able to relax out, and it's not coming off of that rotor face, okay? And that's where you get these grooves getting cut in. The same reason why this rotor on the inboard is in this condition, right? There's a ton of rust. This is actually the same reason why this pad is frozen in the bracket, okay? Again, the outside gets a lot of airflow, is able to get dried off relatively quickly, where the inside doesn't have as much airflow to be able to allow it to dry. Now, this is why we say it's so imperative to make sure you clean and lubricate your pads, okay? So that it allows free moving, especially now on these inboards that don't have a lot of airflow to support it. So now our solution to this is going to be, we're going to put a fully coated rotor on. Okay, that way it helps against this rust jacking. Again, we're in the rust belt, so we really need to try and do everything we can to help prolong these breaks. So that the fully coated rotor, along with cleaning and lubricating underneath the hardware and top the hardware, the back of the pads, is gonna help prolong this brake life.